Hello my children, good afternoon, I hope you are doing well. So today we are going to discuss about the Brahmaputra river basin. In earlier video, we have learned about the Ganga river basin, right? So today we are going to discuss the Brahmaputra river basin. Now the Brahmaputra river basin, it originates from glacier near Mansarovar Lake. In earlier you have learned about the Ganga river, where it originate? It originate from Gangotri glaciers, right? So we see this, the Brahmaputra river, where it originate. It originate in Siambangdam glacier near Mansarovar Lake. As this river flow it starts in Tibet, where it is known as River Tsangpo. Now my dear children, in different place this river is known by the different names. As it starts flowing from Tibet, where it is known as River Tsangpo. Got it my children? Now this river flows in three countries. So in which three countries this Brahmaputra river flows? It flows in India, China and Bangladesh. Now let's talk about in India where it flows and how this river entering India. What it my children? Now let's start. Now this Brahmaputra river, as it flows parallel to the mountain, right? As it flows parallel to the mountain, from the mountain it cannot jump and come in our country, right? It should get some space to enter. So where this Brahmaputra river, where this river gets space to enter in India? So two mountains are there, that is a Gyalaperi and another is Namcha Barwa mountain. From these two mountains it gets a space to enter in India. So it enters between these two mountains, it enters in India through Arunachal Pradesh. So first where it enters, in which state? That is Arunachal Pradesh, where this river is known as River Dihang. As I told earlier that in different place this river is known by different names. When it is in Tibet, it is known as River Tsangpo. But when it enters India through Arunachal Pradesh, so this river is known as River Dihang. What is known as? River Dihang. As it flows through the valley of Assam and it takes a turn to the south. As it flows after entering Arunachal Pradesh, it goes down and it flows through the valley of Assam, so it takes a south turn to enter Bangladesh, where it meets River Padma, a tributary of Ganga. Now my dear children, you are confused about tributary. Earlier we have learned about the tributaries. Yes, so what is tributary? A river which joins the main river. That is a small river which joins the main river, that is a tributary. Now what is distributary? Now distributary means the channel that come out of the main river. A river branch which does not directly go to the main river, it distributed water. That is known as distributary. Got it my children? A river which does not come back to the main river, it distributes water. So this Padma, this river, as the Ganga when it flows, it comes to the place where it is known as River Padma. The Ganga name changed over there and it is known as River Padma. It is the water of Ganga. So when the Brahmaputra and Ganga, when they meet, they form a large delta in the world before entering in Bay of Bengal. Got it my children? Hope till here you have understood about the how it entered and which name is Brahmaputra is known in which place. And then you might you have understood about the distributaries. Got it? So when Brahmaputra and Ganga, when they meet before entering into Bay of Bengal, they form a large delta. Now what is this large delta? Let's talk about the delta. Now what is delta? As I said you, like when Ganga and Brahmaputra, when they enter before Bay of Bengal, they form a large delta. Right? So what is delta? Delta is a triangular piece of land which is formed at the mouth of river. Right? Now how it is formed? It is formed when a river deposits the sediment as it flows toward its mouth. Now what is sediment? Now my dear children, take example. Suppose if you are in a slope, if you want to come down, without wasting your energy, you will directly come down. And then when you will come in the plane, you will again you have to put your energy to run. Got it, my children? So same over in the river also. When the river, when it flows from the slope, it carries a lot of sediment along with us. Right? And when it comes to the plain area, it loses power. And then it throws all the sediments to the plain area. Got it, my children? What I said? Now listen. Now when the river, when it flows from the slope, right? When it flows from the slope, it is in very energetic. It is in very energetic mode. So when it flows from the slope, it carries a lot of soil along with us. Lot of sediment along with us. So when it reaches towards the mouth of river, it loses power. And it deposits its sediment at the mouth of river. So in that place the delta is formed. Got it, my children? Hope you have understood about the delta. Now, when Ganga and Brahmaputra, they form a large delta in the world, that is known as Sundarban Delta. What is Sundarban Delta? The Sundarban Delta is a beautiful in the world. If you will go and you will see the Sundarban Delta, it is so beautiful. There are a variety of animals and aquatic animals, reptiles will farm in that place. Anyone that Sundarban Delta, that place is very fertile. Because of its fertility, the name is given, a nickname is given, that is the Green Delta. Got it, my children? Now, here in Sundarban Delta, you will find a variety of animal, wild animal. One example about the tiger, that is the Bengal tiger. Bengal tiger is also found in Sundarban Delta. And also, in the Sundarban Delta, you will see a large mangrove forest. Large mangrove forest is also found in Sundarban Delta. Got it, my children? Sundarban Delta is also the home of more than 250 tigers. Got it, my children? Now, as you enter the adventures of Sundarban Delta, you will thrill to see the animals, reptiles, animals, wild animals and aquatic animals. So, because of it, Sundarban Delta is enlisted its name in the Wonder of Nature. As you know, 7 wonder of world, that is a Taj Mahal. So same here, Sundarban Delta also enlisted this name, its name in the 7 wonders of nature. Now, as I talk about the fertility of land, so here the major crop is grown, that is rice, maize, oilseed, pulses, etc. Got it, my children? Hope you have understood about the Brahmaputra River Basin. Thank you.